Dear students, you are familiar with our country, India. Most of you have some ideas about it through maps, pictures, photographs, documentaries, films, satellite imageries, and news that you come across on daily basis. But India is much more than what is depicted through all these. It is the seventh largest country in terms of area and second largest in terms of population in the world. Unlike other large countries, unity in diversity is the essence of India. Diversity in terms of its geological structure, ranging from old peninsular block and Aravalli hills to young deltas and alluvial plains, relief and physical features ranging from lofty Himalayas to low-lying islands and coastal plains, climate ranging from wettest Cherrapunji and Mausinram to driest Thar desert and cold desert Ladakh, natural vegetation ranging from equatorial tropical evergreen and tidal mangrove forests to xerophytes of Indian deserts are only a few of many diverse features of its geography. These physical diversities have played significant role in the enrichment of India's socio-cultural diversities in terms of religion and faith and beliefs, livelihood, ways of life, culture, language, food habits, population composition, economic achievement, and technological advancement. India has a distinction among all the countries of the world with harmonious coexistence of various religions, speakers of many languages, and practitioners of various cultures and ways of life over many centuries. These diversities have continuously added new flavor in the enrichment of the sense of unity and belonging among the Indians. The role played by the mountain walls in its north and Indian Ocean in the south created unique arena of interplay of various natural and social factors, which in turn have contributed in making India a melting pot of cultures and ways of life which needs unending celebration from one and all. However, above all these lies the Indian monsoon, operating as an important synthesizing factor between relief and climate, nature and society, economy and politics in India. Similarly, the dense network of perennial rivers act like the lifelines of India's culture and economy, and these have always reinforced the bond of oneness among its diverse natural, socio-cultural attributes. The Class 11 Geography textbook's India Physical Environment makes a humble attempt to awaken the young mind about the rich and diverse aspect of India's physical environment, location and space relations, geological structures and physiography, drainage systems and climate, natural vegetation and soil, natural hazards and disasters. Though the textbook has all these to enrich the understanding of India, yet knowledge cannot be and should not be restricted to textbook only. An ideal way to understand India is to visit all its parts and interact with diverse environment and different people on continuous basis. But there are limitations to do all these. Moreover, all are not fortunate enough to accompany such luxury. Therefore, the NCERT always tries to update the knowledge about India and impart the same to millions of students using latest technology like e-resources, e-text, e-tutorials, video lectures, and enrichment material supplementing textbooks, self-assessment inventories, checklist, external web links, and many more activities which makes learning smooth and joyful. I hope you will take advantage of all these programs and give your feedback to me, B.S. Butola, Professor at Center for the Study of Regional Development, and colleagues and team members, MOOCs NCERT, New Delhi. Thank you.